New here at 3, respiratory therapy is becoming one of the fastest growing occupations in the country.
Respiratory therapist shortage.
A national shortage of RTs.
The job is in such high demand.
Health experts say the need for RTs will only increase after the pandemic.
Motivated, calm under pressure, and always adapting, respiratory therapists are trained to deal with conditions affecting the lungs and heart. That commonly includes asthma, emphysema, and COPD. But RTs also handle the highest acuity cases, meaning they keep people alive when everything goes south.
In those high-stakes situations, it's very, very rewarding to have learned something in school and then actually get a chance to help save this person's life.
We are like in the heart of the storm. When things go bad, the first person you call is your respiratory therapist.
There's really not much that I haven't seen.
On a regular basis, respiratory therapists are called in to provide life-saving care. If you're familiar with the excitement and intensity of TV hospital dramas,
it's actually pretty accurate a lot of times.
When the lungs aren't working well, patients aren't getting enough oxygen. RTs have tools and techniques available to restore that oxygen supply, like CPAP and ventilators.
You always got on the troubleshooting mode before you even walk through the door.
Maybe go into a C-section, 8 a.m., and then next thing I know, there's a cardiac arrest coming in the ER. I'm up on the pediatric floor, and I'm taking care of a patient with cystic fibrosis.
I like bouncing around from one side of the hospital to the other, never knowing what I'm going to be doing in 5 minutes.
You just never know what you're going to walk into. The change just keeps it interesting.
Many people come to MU Healthcare just to tackle some of the most complex cases, caring for infants and children.
I mean, we do all the way from little 23-week neonate.
The little one-pound babies all the way to geriatrics. The families are scared. Like, this is their child. Their child is sick. They've never seen him like this. I mean, this is the worst day of their life.
They might serve in the neonatal ICU or on the pediatric transport team, performing high adrenaline rescues.
It's very rewarding to walk in and everybody's like, oh, thank God you're here. I just feel like I walk in with a cape on because I know I have the skills. I know that I can take care of that patient.
With the little babies, you see them go home when they're in the NICU for a year and a half. They kind of grow up with you. I have a couple that I still stay in touch with. I get photos and videos all the time.
For many RTs, it's about feeling needed and valued.
They give me a sense of purpose. I'm okay, now I gotta go help somebody that needs my help.
And the healthcare field provides a sense of stability.
In healthcare, there will always be sick people, so you'll always have a job.
Of course, there's no reward quite like watching patients begin to feel like themselves again.
You really get to build personal connections with a lot of those patients, and it's really exciting to celebrate those like achievements.
And you see them kind of like prosper and, you know, make it to the loved ones.
At the end of the day, if I've saved or improved a life, then that's success.
But no one shoulders this mission alone.
We depend on each other.
They're almost like a security blanket. It's really great to work with people that you trust and you know that are gonna take the best care of your patients.
You can count on people that are blessed with like a crazy amount of knowledge. So you know that you're not walking there alone.
Choosing a career isn't easy, but it helps to narrow things down first.
I knew that I wanted to be in healthcare. Nursing was always kind of in the back of my mind.
I didn't want to wear dress clothes and I was like, scrubs, like wears like pajamas every day. That's awesome. 3 days a week, I mean, I can do that. I wanted to help people.
If you think respiratory therapy might be for you, come test drive it. Young people can job shadow RTs for a taste of what's involved.
Either they're super excited and just can't believe we do all that stuff, or they're like, yeah, this is not for me, and they almost pass out. So it could go either way.
You can even start making a real-world impact while you're still in college.
We hire respiratory therapy students. So even before you've graduated from your program, we can hire you and use you and start training you as a respiratory therapist.
A lot of the other therapists that I work alongside, they've become mentors and they have helped me to grow. I feel like I really get to practice and fine-tune a lot of the skills that I'm learning in class.
And if you want to keep your options open, you couldn't have picked a better job.
You become well-rounded. That prepares you to go into a multitude of different areas.
Yeah. You're always needed. If you want to be part of the action, just be needed and want to be everywhere, be an RT. Things are going down, they're going to call you.